So the next part is deficiency diseases. Like we have done that all the nutrients should be present in the diet. What are the components of the diet? What is the nutritional value? How should we cook the food? So now we are doing that. What will happen if we will not get the proper nutrient or a particular type of nutrient in our diet? What will happen if we will not get iodine, if we will not get iron, if we will not get vitamins in a proper amount, what disease our body will suffer? Okay, so let us start. So if our body doesn't have vitamin A, it will be suffering from night blindness. In night blindness, the people, they are able to see in the dim light, or they lost the vision at night. Then vitamin B1, if someone is having deficiency of vitamin B1, the person will be suffering from beriberi. In beriberi, the person will get the weakening of muscles, digestion problem, heart problems, nervous system problems. And if vitamin B2 is in deficient amount, then the person will be having skin diseases like cracked skin. Vitamin B3 deficiency causes pellagra. Pellagra is a digestive or nervous system related problem, and it also affects the skin. Then vitamin B12, its shortage gives you the problem of anemia, because it helps in the formation of red blood cells. So if vitamin B12 is not present in the proper amount in your body, then your RBCs will not be formed, and thus you will be anemic. Then the deficiency of vitamin C causes scurvy. Scurvy is the problem of bleeding gums. Like from your gums, the blood came out when you brush your teeth. It means that your body lacks vitamin C. Then vitamin D, its deficiency causes rickets. That is the weakening of bones, joints, swelling of joints, weakening of bones, bending of bones. All these is because of vitamin D deficiency. That is known as rickets. Then vitamin K deficiency, it causes hemorrhage. What is this hemorrhage? Hemorrhage is difficulty in clotting of blood. That if you get any cut, then your blood will keep on flowing through that cut. It will not get clot. Okay, if there is the deficiency of vitamin K in your body. Then now let us talk about some minerals which we need from in our diet. That is calcium. The deficiency of calcium causes osteoporosis or rickets. Rickets, because if your body has proper amount of calcium, then vitamin D can be formed in the proper amount. Now this also leads to the weakening of bones. Then if your body doesn't have the proper amount of iron, then you will be anemic, that you will be having pale skin, loss of weight will occur. Then if you are having deficiency of phosphorus, then again it will lead to the rickets. Then iodine deficiency causes goiter. That is the enlargement of thyroid gland, which is present near your neck. Okay. Then sodium and potassium are also important for us. If they are not present in the proper amount, you will feel weakness of muscles or paralysis will occur. Okay, students. So in this way, all these are very much important for all of us. And if we don't have any of these nutrient, vitamin or mineral, we will be suffering from any of these deficiency diseases. Okay, students. Thank you. Have a nice day.